Chapter 1. Intro.
Hello.
Hello, everyone. Before we get started, this first clip goes out to everyone who thinks my videos are 100% AI generated. Here's a behind-the-scenes peek at what this video looks like in Premiere Rush. Real editing, real timeline, real chaos. And welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, we share smart home tips, product reviews, and step-by-step guides to make your home smarter, more efficient, and way cooler. If that sounds like your thing, go ahead and smash that subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any future videos. Today, we're checking out yet another budget-friendly gadget, the 40W Tuya ZigBee RGB CW ceiling light, straight from the mysterious depths of AliExpress. Will this be a hidden gem? Or will it burst into flames upon installation? Stick around to find out.
Chapter 2. Disclaimer.
Before we get started, let's clear the air. This video is not sponsored by AliExpress, Tuya, ZigBee Overlords, or any secret societies dedicated to illuminating the world one questionable gadget at a time. I bought this with my own hard-earned money, so what you're getting is a brutally honest, no corporate nonsense review. And as always, if this thing turns out to be a total dud, you'll hear about it, loud and clear. Now let's crack this box open and see what we're dealing with.
Chapter 3. What's in the box?
Okay, let's see what surprises AliExpress has in store for us today. Drumroll, please. The lamp itself. Let's hope it does more than just sit there looking pretty. A mounting base plate already attached to the lamp, because levitating lamps haven't been invented yet. Terminal blocks to hopefully prevent me from turning my ceiling into an unintended light show. Two screws with wall plugs, theoretically enough to keep the lamp on the ceiling and not crashing onto my face in the middle of the night. An instruction manual, which, as expected, is about as useful as a solar-powered flashlight in a pitch-dark cave. Now, let's take a closer look at the lamp. First impressions? Not bad. The build quality feels surprisingly solid for the price. The design is sleek and it should blend well in most rooms. However, the user manual? Completely useless. Instead of actual ZigBee pairing instructions, I got a guide on how to connect it to Amazon Alexa, Samsung SmartThings, Philips, and Smart Life Hubs, but not a single word about ZigBee. Because, obviously, who would ever buy a ZigBee lamp and expect to use it with ZigBee, right? If you love numbers and specs, here's what we're working with. Model, XHTZ2C. Material, ABS. Rated power, 40 watts. Voltage, 90 to 250 volts, 50-60 hertz. Color, RGBCW, RGB for the disco vibes, plus cold and warm white. So you can fine-tune your whites from ice cave to cozy fireplace. Size, big enough to make a statement, but not full-on UFO size. 37 centimeters in diameter and 3 centimeters thin. The grand total? 42 pounds and 11 pence, with free shipping from China, arriving in just 7 days. Not too shabby. But was it worth it? Only one way to find out. Time for installation. Wish me luck!
Chapter 4. Physical installation.
Installation is pretty straightforward. But before anything else, turn off the power at the circuit breaker. Seriously, unless you're auditioning for a role as a lightning rod, just don't. Electricity is no joke. Safety comes first, always. And if you're not confident or qualified, hire a licensed electrician. No shame in staying alive. I'd already removed my old ceiling lamp, so I could go ahead and mount the new base plate to the ceiling using the provided screws. Easy enough. Next up, wiring. Make sure to match live and neutral correctly, unless you want your smart home to star in its own ghost hunting series. Thankfully, the cables are color-coded. At least they should be. Double-check the colors in your country. If you're in the UK, the standard since 2004 is live brown. neutral, blue, earth, green, and yellow. This lamp only comes with live and neutral wires, no earth. Is that ideal? Probably not. But I'm not an electrician, so I'll leave the debate to the professionals. All I can say is connect what's there properly and hope for the best. Once all the wires are securely connected, attach the lamp to the base plate and lock it in place. And let me be brutally honest, locking the lamp into the base plate was the most frustrating part. What should have taken 30 seconds somehow turned into an Olympic event. It took me over 5 minutes of awkward fiddling, borderline swearing, and gravity-defying wrist angles. Don't worry, I've spared you the pain by cutting most of that struggle from the video. You're welcome. Now it's safe to flip the power back on at the breaker and fire up your brand new ceiling light. If everything's wired correctly, it should light up like a Christmas tree, but with more elegance and far fewer pine needles. If it doesn't, well, grab your tester, double-check those connections, and maybe reconsider that electrician idea.
Chapter 5. Home Assistant Setup.
All right. The lamp is installed, nobody got electrocuted, and the ceiling hasn't collapsed. So let's bring this shiny disc into our smart home universe. Since this device speaks ZigBee, you'll need a ZigBee-compatible hub. I'm using ZigBee 2 MQTT integration with Home Assistant, so everything you'll see here is based on that setup. Step 1. Pairing, lamp meets world. Time to introduce your new ceiling light to the smart home network. Think of this as the first date between your lamp and your smart home. Open ZigBee 2 MQTT integration page and click Permit Join to start pairing mode. Power on your lamp. If it's brand new, it'll likely flash a few times, like it's excited to meet everyone. If it doesn't blink or show up, don't panic. Try the classic ZigBee trick. Turn the ceiling light on and off several times quickly until it starts blinking like it's trying to communicate in Morse code. That usually forces ZigBee devices into pairing mode. Give it a few seconds. If the stars align, a new device should appear. If not, try again. Or bribe the lamp with compliments. Worst case, you feel better about yourself. Step 2. Naming. Don't be that person. Avoid the nightmare of unnamed device lurking in your smart home forever. Go to your ZigBee 2 MQTT interface. Click Rename Device. And pick something that actually makes sense. I named mine LEDs P Better Ceiling. LEDs, obvious because, well, it's an LED lamp. P Bed R, parents' bedroom, because it's installed there. Ceiling, so I don't mistake it for a floor lamp or a sentient AI light trying to take over my house. Before you finalize the renaming, make sure to enable Update Home Assistant Entity ID so the new name updates across your smart home setup. If you like extra tips on naming your smart devices, check out my video, The Perfect Naming Conventions. Simplify your smart home. You can click the link in the top right corner now or watch it later using the link in the description below. Step 3. Adjust key settings. Now let's tweak a few things so this lamp doesn't behave like a rebellious teenager blasting music at 2 a.m. Start by opening your shiny new ceiling light from the ZigBee 2 MQTT integration page. Just click its name. Add a description in the About tab. Totally optional, but it might save your sanity months down the line when something inevitably breaks. I wrote, Ceiling RGB LED light in parents' bedroom. Does not respond to clapping. Yes, I tried. No, it didn't work. Yes, I felt ridiculous. Next, head to the Settings Specific tab and set state action to true. This tells Home Assistant when the lamp is actually on or off. Unlike my neighbor, who still hasn't realized his car alarm has been going off for 2 years. Then go to the Exposes tab and look for Do Not Disturb. I set mine to false, but if you prefer the lamp not to light up like a surprise interrogation scene after a power outage, set it to true. Your sleep-deprived future self will thank you. Lastly, tweak the color power on behavior setting. I set mine to previous so it remembers the last color and brightness, because nothing says smart home like not getting blinded by full white LEDs in the middle of the night. And doom! Your lamp now behaves like a civilized smart device, not a wild RGB disco ball with commitment issues. Step 4. Add location and labels. Let's get organized so your home assistant doesn't turn into a digital game of Where's Wally. Open Home Assistant Settings. head to Devices and Services. Then switch over to the Devices tab. Find your shiny new lamp and click on it. Hit the little pencil icon in the top right to enter edit mode. Assign it to a room, something practical like parents' bedroom, garage, or unicorn command center. Whatever keeps your smart home chaos from becoming full-blown science fiction anarchy. You can also add labels to make future automations easier. Click update and you're done. Congratulations. Your ZigBee RGB ceiling LED lamp is now paired, named, configured, labeled, and fully integrated with Home Assistant. Basically one firmware update away from sentience. Now comes the real test. Does it actually work? Or is it just sitting there, silently judging you in a slow, passive-aggressive rainbow fade?
Chapter 6, Dashboard.
Let's add our shiny new ceiling lamp to the Home Assistant dashboard. Start by opening your dashboard and clicking the pencil icon in the top right corner to enter edit mode. Next, smash that big Add Card button in the bottom right like you're unlocking a hidden level. In the card selection window, scroll through and pick your favorite. Personally, I'm all about the Mushroom Light Card. It's sleek, versatile, and perfect for RGB lights of all shapes and brightness levels. So that's the one I'm going with. If you want to use Mushroom Cards too but have no clue where to find them, here's a pro tip. The only way to install Mushroom Cards is through hacks. And if you're now thinking, wait, what on earth is hacks? Don't panic. I've got a whole video for that. How to install Hacks 2.x in Home Assistant 2025. Step-by-step guide. Click the link in the top right corner now or find it later in the description below. Okay, back to the dashboard setup. I selected my ceiling light as the entity and named the new control Ceiling RGB Lamp. Then I enabled a few extra options to make things awesome. Use light color so the dashboard reflects the current glow of the lamp. Brightness control, because sometimes you want mood lighting and sometimes you want airport runway. Temperature and color control, for tweaking the white light warmth to your liking. Color control, for full RGB party mode. Collapse controls when off, so I'm not staring at a bunch of unusable sliders when the light's off. Hit save when you're done tweaking your new control and position the new card wherever you like on your dashboard. Treat it like furniture in The Sims. I parked mine right under the light switches for easy access. Finally, click Done in the top right corner to exit edit mode. And just like that, your new light control is live and ready to shine. Enjoy the glow!
Chapter 7, Tests.
Sadly, there's not much to test here, but let's poke around and see what this lamp can do anyway. Time to play with colors, temperature, and brightness. Good news! The lamp responds super quickly and everything works exactly as expected. Unfortunately, my trusty camera can't quite capture the changes in brightness, but take my word for it, it's working beautifully. Honestly, I'm very happy with it. No smoke, no sparks, no drama, just light. Glorious, colorful light.
Chapter 8. The verdict.
So, was this AliExpress purchase a win or a fail? For the price, definitely a win. This smart ceiling light is surprisingly impressive. The build quality feels solid, the response time is snappy, the color range is wide, and you can even adjust the white light temperature. Fancy stuff for something that didn't cost a fortune. But of course, no budget gadget is without its quirks. I found three minor downsides. It was way more frustrating than expected to lock the lamp into the base plate, at least for me. Maybe it's just me, or maybe it's the lamp. Either way, be prepared to wrestle a bit. Sadly, this lamp doesn't seem to support over-the-air firmware updates. It doesn't show up at all in the OTA tab in the ZigBee 2 MQTT integration. So what you buy is what you're stuck with, forever, like that tattoo you got in college. After a power cut, the lamp takes about a minute, or sometimes longer, to show as online again. This isn't unusual for ZigBee devices, but it's something to keep in mind. If you plan to power it via a traditional wall switch, just know there'll be a short wait before you can start playing light show DJ again. Would I buy it again? Absolutely. For this price? No doubt. It's not perfect, but it shines where it counts.
Chapter 9. Thank you.
That's the end of this bright little adventure. Thanks for tagging along as we installed, configured, and mildly interrogated this ZigBee ceiling lamp without anything catching fire. That's a big win in my book. Enjoyed the ride? Learned something new? Or at least chuckled once? Smash that like button. It feeds the algorithm and keeps this channel from disappearing into the void of the internet. Subscribe if you haven't already and tap that bell so you don't miss any future smart home shenanigans. Got questions, feedback, or a smarter way to do it? Drop a comment below. I read them all, even the ones that gently roast my cable management. Feeling generous? Want to help me keep the lights on literally and figuratively? You can support the channel via Buy Me a Coffee, PayPal, or Patreon. All the links are in the description below. Thanks again for tuning in, and remember, keep it smart, keep it simple, and never trust a light that doesn't blink at least once during setup. Happy color switching!